that a little bit later on, but let's start with this. Let's start with this comment first. This is from 2020 onwards. So he says, he or she says, Bitcoin has some flaws. I'm well aware that it is one of mankind's greatest inventions. It has the capacity and capability of becoming the base layer for money, but it could do with one of the following tweaks. So here's how 2020 onwards would change Bitcoin. He appreciates the fact that it is good money, greatest invention, but here's how he would change Bitcoin. Says, number one, at least 5 million Bitcoin are lost forever. A lot of Bitcoin owners don't fully trust their spouse with their seed phrase, so we can expect that 16 million total supply to be 10 million by 2040. So he's saying that there's been Bitcoin lost and he expects much more Bitcoin to be lost for that reason. People will continue to die, taking their seed phrase to the grave. Taking that into account, it should be voted on by the devs and node operators that from 2026 onwards, Bitcoin's max supply increases by 200,000K Bitcoin per year for 75 years. So that's a legit point. He's saying that, you know, there's lots of Bitcoin that's already lost. Most people are well aware of that. I don't think that that's priced into Bitcoin, honestly, but Bitcoiners know that. And he says that more and more people will continue to lose their Bitcoin through death or through stubbornness to set up their inheritance planning with their family. And I absolutely agree with that as well. So he thinks that we should vote on it, or the devs and the node operators should vote on a supply increase of 20,000 Bitcoin per year for the next 75 years. So that's number one. And then also he says, number two is very few people will use it for anything other than store of value, which defeats the purpose, half defeats the purpose. So let's touch on, I think that what I'm going to say to that, my response is kind of falls under the same thing. So what I would say with that comment is that those are very valid points. It makes sense that because there's so much Bitcoin that's lost and going to be lost, we should consider increasing the supply instead of decreasing every year. But what I would say to that is, both of these points are, they just make Bitcoin more scarce. That's all it does. And the number itself does not matter. So it's 21 million Bitcoin. That's how many will ever exist. But that's just a number. It could have been 210 million Bitcoin. The price would be a little bit less, how much people are willing to pay for it. But it doesn't matter how much Bitcoin there is. The only thing that matters is that it's fixed. It's fixed and transparent, and the supply schedule is known. So it could be 21 billion Bitcoin. It doesn't matter, because as people continue to lose Bitcoin and people continue to use it for a store of value instead of for actual currency, it's going to become more scarce. And so when it becomes more scarce, all we're going to do is move the zeros, move the decimal points. So right now we price things in Bitcoin. In 10 years from now, we won't know what the price of Bitcoin is. We'll only know what the price of a sat is. And then 10 years from there, we're not going to know what a sat is anymore. We're just going to know what a microsat costs. And that's kind of how I see this whole thing playing out. So both of these very good points, but you're missing the fact that the number is irrelevant. The only thing that matters is the scarcity and the fixed supply of Bitcoin. Does that make sense? And so over time, even if the supply actually continues to shrink, people lose it, people lock it up forever, the actual circulating supply of Bitcoin shrinks. All that's going to do is make the actual Bitcoin more valuable. And we're just going to keep moving the decimal points for it to make sense to us as humans. That's all we're going to do. It's all just numbers. So the actual max supply itself does not matter. The fact that it's fixed matters. So great points. I definitely do not agree that we should be increasing the supply of Bitcoin ever. I think that it'll defeat the whole purpose of it. I think that if we ever voted in a supply increase, that would change the whole dynamic of Bitcoin. And the beauty of it is that it has been unchanged. We've added a couple things, some soft forks along the way, just improving it. But if you actually go and change the supply schedule, we're basically going to be Ethereum at that point. And then maybe from there, we'll switch to proof of stake instead of proof of work. So great points. I do not agree with either of those. We should not be increasing the supply of Bitcoin. Defeats the purpose of it. So that's how I wanted to start the show today. Cito, look at this comment. I've been called a Bitcoin thumper